Hello guys, in this quick video I'm going to do some work on this DELL Latitude 3570 laptop. Okay, first thing I want to show you its specs. It's a Windows 10 Pro machine. This is the first laptop, computer, whatever that I'm working on, which actually comes with a Windows 10 license directly, and it's not just an upgrade. It has an i5-6200U, 2.3 GHz, two slots of DDR3. It is still DDR3, not DDR4. I wonder when I will work on something with DDR4. Should get to it. It has one stick of 4 gigabytes of memory and a 500 gigabytes hard drive, and it still has a DVD writer. I wonder where. Yeah, it obviously doesn't. So they made an error. That is not correct right there. This thing doesn't have an optical drive. It does have card readers and whatnot, but zero optical drives for sure. And this thing came without a charger. Yeah, in here I think I have some memory. No, I do have some memory, but this is the wrong memory. This is the memory that I'm going to put in this laptop, and let's get it out of this bag, which is 100% not suited for holding memory in. Ta-da. Yeah, it's only 2 GB, I know. Could be way more than this, but 6 GB is better than 4 GB. And honestly, in 2018 on Windows 10, on a non-gaming computer, 6 GB is still enough. I can tell you that for sure. So this thing came without a charger. I needed to buy a charger. It is a second-hand charger, and it is original. I only buy original chargers lately. I started to hate aftermarket chargers, because the cheap ones are crappy made, and the expensive ones are about the same price as the original ones. So yeah, nothing to gain there. But as you can see, this is not an original, or actually it is an original plug, but not for a slim charger like this one. It's from a, let me just show you, maybe I have a Dell around here. Nope, no Dells around me. The original charger for this plug is thicker, so this looks really bad, and I need to replace it with something else, with something like this. It's the same plug, but it looks way sleeker and cleaner. But now there is another problem, which I realized. Too many cables around here. Let me try and get rid of some stuff. That's not going to be easy. Okay, got rid of that thing. Don't need it no more. This thing was repaired. You can see the marks right here. I don't have a particular problem with somebody repairing this thing, because they tried to do a decent job. This is not cracked, not so. They opened it up nicely, repaired it, put it back together. I repair stuff, so it is a decent job. I'm not afraid of this repair, and I don't have a problem with it. But I do have a problem with the fact that this plug, let me try and show you, wiggles. And the plug itself wiggles, not just the cable. So I need to put some glue all around this connector, because I do not want that connector to wiggle, because that means that either the board on which the connector is glued, soldered, sorry, wiggles inside this thing, which is bad once again, or there are wires going from this to the board and the wires are wiggling and they could break. So I need to glue this thing into position. So let's get to doing that. I'm going to use 5 minutes epoxy. I need something that dries up rather quickly, so I can make sure it doesn't drip all around. I'm going to let this thing dry for way more than 5 minutes to make sure it is all okay. And then we will continue working on this really nice laptop. Okay, so I think about a week passed since I have worked on this thing, because I have no free time at all. And just an advice, if you have too much free time, just make a baby. It will be gone. Okay, so hopefully this thing is dry up until now. And it's quite impossible for it not to be. And this is wiggling just... or is it? What is wiggling here? Oh yeah, it's just... how to say this? The plug itself in the connector, not the connector in the case. And the wiggling is minimum. So we did what we set out to do. Yeah. Let's connect everything up and see if this thing powers on, or actually, no, I think I'm going to upgrade it first. Yeah, let's go for broke. Don't power it on, upgrade it first, and if it does not power on, try and think what you did wrong. Yeah, let's do it the wrong way. As I said, let's upgrade this thing before we power it on. Remove the battery. That is the ideal thing to do, and I just remember this thing actually has a Windows 10 license on it. Probably I already said this, but it will be the first time I actually work on a native Windows 10 device. So that's going to be a bit weird, because I'm expecting normally to install... why are you not coming out? To install Windows 7 and... or 8 and upgrade it to Windows 10, but this thing will actually directly run Windows 10. And this thing has some clips in here if you need to open yours up, a screwdriver or some of these things should do the trick. And my phone is ringing, so I'll be back in a moment. Okay, let's continue. So you could use this. I normally do, but this time again we are doing this the wrong way around. So this is removed, and this is a pretty nice nice system. We have a tiny Wi-Fi card in here, pretty cool. Tiny cable, a SATA, like that. Let me just show you the original memory so you can see its specs. You actually need to upgrade yours. Okay. Let's put this thing back in. I don't really like this connector. It doesn't make the clicking noise. Yeah, anyway. Should still work. And this is what I'm going to put in, and hopefully it will work. If not, well, yeah, we will see when we get there, won't we? So push it inside the slot and then push it down, and this time it actually clicked, which is good. And if you want to upgrade your hard drive, this should be rather easy. You have four screws. I'm just showing you because this has a 500 gig hard drive. Not really interested in any upgrades at this point in time. And what is a bit annoying, if I'm looking at this thing, I don't see the possibility to add, I don't know, an mini PCIe SSD or an M.2 or something. I might be missing it and maybe it's hidden somewhere, but yeah. Talk to us in the comments if you know how to do that, and if it's possible, people might find it useful. So this is our hard drive. You simply remove the connector gingerly. Yeah, not like that. So you do not yank it out of the motherboard. That is not the way how you do it. So I'm going to try with the screwdriver right in here. It has a few places where you can actually insert it. Man, this is tight. What the? This is not the standard. This thing is normally. They are not this tight. So if you want to remove this hard drive, you will need a slim one. I don't know if I have a thick one. Yeah, I think I have one. So I will show you what that means. So that could be a trap. Be very careful when you buy it. This is a thick hard drive. Yeah, it's in a caddy, but you can still see the difference. So if you upgrade this hard drive, make sure it is a thin one. And either upgrade it to a really big SSD, I don't know, 500 gigabytes or something like that, or buy an SSHD, which actually is a normally spinning hard drive, and it has an SSD part in it for caching the most used files. That is really good. I have a few of those in some laptops, and they do a really good job. So let's put this back. You would take these four screws out, take this out of the caddy, put the new one in, put the four screws back, and then continue with the connector and put this thing back in place. I really am curious. I don't really have time to investigate online if you can add an SSD or something in any other way to this thing than replacing this. That would kind of suck. I don't know, but there is a chance that this is the only way it can actually be done. But sometimes they have room for stuff like that under the keyboard, so couldn't really say, guys. I will try to do a bit of online digging until the end of this video and tell you what I can come up with. And let's put everything right back from where we got them. And hopefully this thing will actually power on. I'm not going to even bother testing it, because we are doing it the wrong way. Normally you should try and test it without putting back all the covers, because if it's not working, you then need to take them all out again. But yeah, I'm trusting it will work, and if not, I just made a little bit more work for myself. So let's put the battery back, locked in place. This is a really nice laptop, although if you look at it from the profile, yeah, not that nice, but probably this is some extended battery or something like that, so you can make it thinner if you are into that. Yeah, I know the screen itself is quite dirty. Obviously I will clean this laptop, and my tripod is squeaking white once again. So let's give this power. This is blue, so it is powered. Plug it in. Hopefully we didn't kill anything. Power it on. I have some tiny lights in here, so hopefully it is running. Dells usually require you to hold half a second or something like that onto the power button. Other laptops, you just quickly tap it and they are on. On Dells, you need to hold it a little bit, but this thing is not powering on. So it doesn't like our memory, which is not good, is it? Yeah. Oh well. Nope. I don't know why it didn't start, but yeah, I powered it on once again and it did start. So it sees that the memory has changed. Oh my god, this is some high speed mouse movement in here. Let's go to BIOS setup. And hopefully everything is actually recognized. Oh, it's... what? It's rebooting, so it will go into the BIOS? What? Yeah, this is weird. Yeah, my wife with our little baby making noises. So, yep, we have 6 gigabytes. DDR3L. So this is low voltage memory. I don't think the one that I put in is really low voltage, but it seems to be working. So there are memories that are not low voltage, but they still work at 1.35 volts instead of 1.5. So if they still work, yeah, why not use them? Battery seems to be charged. Yeah, let's see video. Yeah, I was thinking maybe we have some GPU in here. Nope. Anyway, I will do all the tweaks that I usually do and then start installing Windows 10 on this thing, no? That's about the next step. Maybe you saw me making hand gestures, annoyed ones. Well, that is because I don't have the Windows 10 install kit on a USB drive anymore, because the one that I had it on just died. It was a 32 gigabytes, pretty old, and I used it a lot, so it randomly died. And the ones that I do have around are 4 gigabytes, all of them. And the ones that are big enough for Windows 10 have important stuff on them, so I don't have anything to put Windows 10 on. So I will boot from my trusty USB drive that has lots of Windows images on it with all software pre-installed and everything like that. So should be good, should make things way quicker, but in the end, this is not the first laptop onto which I install Windows 10 from zero. It's just a Windows 10 licensed laptop onto which I will put an image and it will activate by itself. So yeah, not what I wanted, but this is what I have at the moment. I'm not going to format this 64 gigabyte hard drive, thumb drive, just to put a Windows 10 installation kit on it. I'm going to use what it already has and what it was intended to be used at. As you can see, Windows 10 is up and running and it was way easier than to install everything from scratch. I plugged in a USB Wi-Fi card because for that one I already have drivers installed on this particular Windows 10 copy. So I can actually start forcing Windows to search online for driver software. And most times Windows 10 actually is able to install drivers. And what I like to do, I start lots of device managers and force them all at once to search, because otherwise it only lets you search for one driver at a time. But every single device manager that you start will let you search for another driver. And I want to search for every single driver possible at the same time, because time is important, you know. And also I will activate Windows, but it gave me a weird error that it cannot access the servers right at this moment, so I will try after I install these drivers. Hopefully most of them will get installed by themselves, which would be awesome. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. So yeah, and these are all of them. You can see here 6 gigs of memory, 64 between those, 2.4 or 2.3 gigahertz CPU. Not really sure. Yeah, it's running at 2.7, which is nice. Yeah, probably it's a dual core plus hyper threading. Yes, it is exactly as I thought. Pretty good, pretty good. Nice laptop. So yeah, it is tinkering for drivers, and it will take sometimes, normally it doesn't really find them really fast, but I will let it do its thing. Okay, so this thing found drivers online for everything. It's downloading the last one right now. This has an exclamation mark next to it. I'm guessing it needs a reboot, and it just installed the one for the last thing, and all drivers are installed at this point, which is awesome. So let's try and activate Windows. What? Connect to internet. I think it actually activated, but I just need to do some sort of refresh. Yep, Windows is activated. Ta-da! So, drivers installed, Windows activated. Let's reboot this thing and then we should give it a clean. Okay, after the restart, the exclamation mark disappeared, so this is perfect. Windows, as you can see, activated. It will probably do a ton of updates. Battery fully charged. Let me just remove the charger. Probably it will take a bit of time until it tells us how much it thinks it will hold. And let me turn off the light. Yep, indeed, this thing has an illuminated keyboard, which I really dig. So, one last thing remaining, I need to clean this up, so let's get to it. And it's finished. And this thing is one of the nicest laptops that I've worked on. 2.74 gigahertz at the moment, turboing, no sound. So it's not heating up at all. Just now it spinned up a little bit. And with 100% disk activity, because updates are going on in the background. Let me try and my tripod will squeak. Let me try and move things. 100% hard drive activity because updates are going on in the background. About 30 and something CPU usage. It still says about 4 hours of battery life. So this thing probably gets around 6 hours of battery in normal use, which is really good. And this really slim charger, yeah, this is a really nice combo. So, you cannot put a SSD in this thing in any other way than by replacing the hard drive, like I already told you. So I was right, sadly. And it allows for 16 gigabytes of RAM, so 2 8 gigabytes sticks if you want to upgrade the memory. But 6 gigs for this thing, at the moment we are using 2 gigs, so I think 6 are enough. And This thing is really nice. Once again, I need to say it. If I would have it my way, probably I would keep this laptop. I might keep this laptop. Yeah, remains to be seen. So, this has been it, guys, for this video. Thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you found it entertaining and at least useful. In which case, please give it a like, check out my other videos, check out my channel, subscribe to my channel, and as always, see you in the next one. Bye.